Thank you. Ms. Haspel, when I joined this committee 7 years ago, I knew as much about the CIA as the average American. Obviously, I know a lot more these days.
Yes.
And much of it can't be shared, but there's two things that I can. The first is that it's very easy to sit back and criticize the work of the agency with the benefit of hindsight. And the second is that the agency is made up of some of the smartest, most talented professionals that I have ever encountered in any field. In my time in public service or beyond. These are men and women that could be making a lot of money in the private sector, but instead they've chosen to serve our country, many in the shadows, many at the risk of their own lives, all to keep us safe. By the way, they sacrificed this money, this time with their family, this normal life in many cases, in defense of the freedoms, including the freedoms of the protesters who often smear them and the activists who often slander them. Ms. Haspel, you embody everything that I respect and admire about the men and women of the Central Intelligence Agency. And I support you not just because of your qualifications, but because I want a young CIA trainee or case officer. I want today's operational officers. I want today's station chiefs. I want today's all of these professionals to know that they too can one day be sitting where you are sitting today and have the opportunity to lead this agency. And I would ask if someone like you, with your history, with your record of service and sacrifice and excellence, if someone like you cannot be confirmed to head this agency, then who can? And if someone like you is smeared in this process, what message are we sending to the young men and women who today are serving our country in the same roles in which you have served our country over the last 30 years? And I thought it was important for that to be part of the record today, because as much as anything else, this hearing is not just about your nomination for me. It is also about the men and women who serve us, of which I said at the outset, you embody the best of the men and women of the